I'm Neil Brown from Federation. I'm happy to be joined by James Chin Moody, founder and CEO of Sendle. Thanks very much for joining us, James.
Thanks for having me.
Excellent. Federation has been an investor in Sendle for 18 months now. Can you tell us a little bit about the company and your customers?
Yeah, sure thing. I mean, Sendle is a company that makes shipping that's good for the world. We do that in a couple of ways. Firstly, we're 100% focused on the needs of small business, helping unlock big business infrastructure for those small businesses. So we help them thrive by making parcel delivery that's simple, reliable, and affordable. And we're also the only 100% carbon neutral parcel delivery service in both Australia and the United States. And together, we think we can actually change this entire industry to be fairer and greener.
And your customer base there, you mentioned, is small business. It's with a particular e-commerce bent, typically. Can you talk about that a little?
Yeah, it turns out that about a third of all parcels are done by these very small and micro businesses. And that industry is growing at an incredible rate. These small businesses are the ones who, you know, you might think about are the ones who are creating a side hustle, or you know, they might have an offline business and they're moving to online. And particularly after this, you know, COVID-19, we're seeing a huge surge of these small businesses. But they're the ones that also need that leg up. You know, it's very hard for them to compete in many ways with the big businesses. And so Sendle comes in, we unlock parcel logistics that they otherwise wouldn't get access to at rates that are cheaper than the incumbents, and we're also faster and better.
Mm-hmm. And how did you discover that there was this problem to address for your customers?
Well, it's really interesting. We actually started our life as a marketplace ourselves where people could give things away. But very quickly, as we started to solve the logistics side of that, we realized that there's this huge share of folk who are basically paying more than they should, and they're getting far less than they should. And these are these small and micro businesses out there. And so we started to dissect that problem, looking, also realizing that they're generally only served by monopoly providers, such as Australia Post. We started dissecting that problem. We found out there were 14 different pain points that a small business has to overcome in order to send a parcel. And so we set up and we just started to solve them one by one until we created a service that we believe, you know, it's there for small business to love.
Mm-hmm. Sendle's a shipping company fundamentally, but with a different business model to traditional shipping companies. Can you talk a little bit about the model?
Yeah, one of the things that we realized was that to be a courier, you don't necessarily need to own all the infrastructure. And in fact, there's lots of trucks on the road. There's lots of, you know, lots of drivers out there. But one of the things is that generally really small business can't access that infrastructure. And so what we do is we work with our partners and we basically become a very asset light or no asset courier company. We can still get parcels from Australia to anywhere in the world. And we can do that cheaper than lining up at the post office. We do that in a way that's very, very scalable, that leverages marginal cost, and that can basically also be more efficient for our partners.
Indeed, and that's a foundation of Federation's investment thesis as well, which is your business is actually creating value for your network partners and actually improving value in the overall system whilst also offering your customers a great service. Can you talk a bit about that sort of flywheel aspect of the business?
Yeah, I think one of the things that we really love about Federation is that we're very, very much aligned. You know, it's got to be good business, but it's also got to be good for the world. And one of the things we found is that you can build this flywheel where you're unlocking idle capacity in networks, but you can do it more efficiently, and then of course we offset the rest to become 100% carbon neutral. Mm-hmm. And that in as you say, it's a flywheel. It basically, the bigger you get, the more scale you get, the more efficiency you can get for both our customers and our suppliers. Mm-hmm.
At Federation, we don't think you have to compromise between ESG and impact principles and financial return. Mm. How do you feel about that topic with respect to your business?
Absolutely. I think if you can get the business model right, which is all about striving for efficiency, right? Waste is unsellable production. Waste is stuff you want to eliminate. And what we try to do is eliminate waste. And that means the more we ship, the better it is for the environment, the better it is for our customers, and you can really align both your positive impact and your business model. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one of the ways that the world is going, because even if in the short term, you know, there's a bit of a trade-off sometimes, in the long term, those things absolutely align around your social license to operate. How efficient is your business? How many contingent liabilities do you have built into your business model? If you can work them out from the very beginning, you're going to have a business that not only does well, but is here for the long term. Mm-hmm.
Federation was attracted to the macro tailwinds to the e-commerce sector and services in that sector. Mm. Certainly there's been a broad and rapid increase in e-commerce take-up over the last little while. How has this impacted Sendle and your views on that into the future?
Look, I think we're already seeing a shift towards e-commerce, quite a significant shift towards e-commerce over the last 10 years. Although what's happened recently, the last 3 months around COVID-19, is basically been one of the largest shifts towards e-commerce the world has ever seen. In fact, we saw more penetration of e-commerce in 3 months than we have seen in the previous 10 years. And I think from our perspective, we're in an interesting space because not only are we seeing increased demand, of course, for courier services for people who are buying stuff online, we're also seeing this big shift for retailers, and particularly the small business retailers, to shift online. So you might say we actually have two tailwinds at the moment that's really driving our business forward.
Mm-hmm. And how has the team managed with the increases in volume, the large increases in volume that you've been experiencing?
Yeah, I think we're very fortunate. We've got an amazing team. You know, our approach was first, let's make sure the team's safe. And then we worked with all of our partners to make sure that our delivery system was we do now 100% contactless pickup and delivery, all included in the price, and we're still cheaper than lining up at the post office. So really, we've scaled very, very nicely during that period.
Sendle has established an office in Seattle now. Can you talk about how the US launch is going and the strategy around growing internationally?
It's really interesting. I mean, we found this huge need in Australia for small businesses who pay more and get less. But when we started to look overseas, we found the exact same problem all over the world, including the United States. And to give us some context, like if you look at the size of the market in America compared to the size of the market in Australia, for the same amount of penetration that we have in the Australian market, we're talking over $1 billion, $2 billion. So we saw a huge opportunity there to, in the same way that we level the playing field for small business in Australia, let's level the playing field for small businesses in the United States as well.
Mm-hmm. And the market dynamics might be a little different in the US to Australia. You've still found the Sendle business model fits in both of those jurisdictions.
Absolutely, I think, and the reason being, because if you just focus on the customer, our thesis is also that you can make a choice. You can either be 80% good to 100% of the market, or you can be 100% good to just one segment of the market. And really one of the things we try to do is we just want to be great for these small and micro businesses out there. Mm-hmm. And by doing that, we unlock a whole lot of opportunity for them, but also I think create an experience that is incredibly, it is differentiated. And adding to the fact that we're the only 100% carbon neutral, I think is something that the both markets in Australia and the United States is something the market's been looking for.
Mm-hmm. And do you see further opportunity in other markets beyond just the US as well?
Yeah, I mean, we have big aspirations, mm-hmm. One step at a time though. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the things though, that again, you look at the rise of e-commerce, you look at the needs of small business, we see that the sort of model that we're pioneering and what we're building is absolutely applicable to other markets as well.
Mm-hmm. So Sendle is a B Corp and Australia's only 100% carbon neutral delivery service. Can you talk about these aspects of the business?
One of the central tenets of our business is that you can actually have a business that is a force for good in the world. And for that reason, from day one, we've actually been what's called a B Corp, which means that you not only have to pass a certain level of accreditation, but you actually have as part of your constitution that you're here for all stakeholders. And in fact, we're Australia's first technology B Corp, and we're starting to see B Corps all over the world, from Patagonia to Ben & Jerry's, and doing very, very well as doing good. From day one, we've thought that aligning the very purpose of our business, why we should exist, with our business model, which is to help small business thrive, that's been a really powerful thing, and it's motivating not only I think for us as a company, but I think it really translates to our entire purpose for why we should be here.
And so how does that translate practically into what you do?
Yeah, not only of course does it mean that we're 100% carbon neutral, but for example we launched the first compostable satchels for Australia and the United States. It means we're very, you know, we measure ourselves in terms of the impact we create, whether it's number of kilometres of carbon neutral parcel delivery or even the amount of Australian GDP for small businesses that we're helping to support. It's very, very deep in the very fabric of our business.
Sendle's recently created some good partnerships. Can you talk more about those?
Yeah, it's interesting. The entire world of e-commerce is quite a huge ecosystem. And in fact, in that ecosystem, there's three main things you do. There's browse, there's buy, and there's ship, which is your shopping cart, your payment gateway, and your shipping provider. And so we've been building partnerships with a range of parties all throughout that entire ecosystem. And probably recent ones that are notable is, for example, we're really helping eBay in Australia and to support them for all of their merchants. And most recently, Shopify has integrated Sendle onto their platform to really remove the friction for small merchants who want to send parcels.
In our view, one of Sendle's strengths is its direct relationship with its customers, which obviously comes with benefits but also responsibility. How do you feel about that topic?
Yeah, it's you're right. I mean, it's amazing. Every day we hear from these small businesses who tell us things like, you know, without you, I wouldn't exist, which is amazing, but it is a huge responsibility. And in fact, Sendle as a company was built on this idea of just taking full responsibility for every delivery, whether that's trying to make sure that the parcel gets there on time, let's take responsibility for the carbon emissions that are created, as those parcels are delivered, because 10% of all carbon emissions are transport and logistics. So that concept of responsibility is really very deep in our DNA.
And can I ask you what Federation's investment has helped the business to achieve?
Yeah, we see the investment from Federation more as a partnership. It's, not only as Federation and through your participation in the board, helped us in terms of thinking through our strategy, but it's also more importantly really thinking through the DNA of the business and what it really means to become a business that's rapidly scaling. And so the experience that Federation's brought to us and the connections have been absolutely invaluable.
And James, where to next for Sendle?
We already have a business that's operating at scale in Australia and growing very strongly. But most excitingly, we're also seeing a huge amount of market traction in the United States. And so when you put those two things together and you really look at us repeating in the US what we've done in Australia, we're looking at a very massive market opportunity and a very massive business indeed. So when we put that together, our experience in Australia together with the potential in the United States, our team is very excited about what the future is going to hold.
Can you share some numbers with us to put that scale in context?
Yeah, well, we've already delivered over 9 billion kilometres of parcel delivery. That's like driving a truck from here to beyond Pluto. We're chasing Voyager right now, 100% carbon neutral. And we're facilitating over $500 million worth of small business e-commerce in Australia now. So, we're already at a certain scale, but of course we're only just scraping the surface of the $100 billion market when you join together the Australia and United and US shipping markets.
Well, James, thanks very much for joining us today. I appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.